Welcome back to Under the Lights here on Hens All Access, and now we're going to take a closer look at Andrew Opoku.
Nice job, Drew!
There you go, Andrew!
Although he is now an integral part of the Blue Hen squad, Andrew Opoku had a long road of personal struggles before he found his home at Delaware.
It was rough for me. When I was at the age of 5, me and my younger sister moved to Ghana with my grandmother. We lived in a village named Goma Sukuma. We were there for about 4 years. I had dreams of coming to America. And that's everyone's dream when they're in Ghana. So those dreams were always being shot down, or you're not gonna come back, or your parents are not gonna come back for you. But I always kept hope because I knew, I always spoke to my mother, and my grandmother always told me that I won't be here for long. You know, so I always reminded my younger sister that we won't be here for long. You know, so don't get too comfortable. In my sense, I believe that was the main part that really shaped me growing up. I was real hyper as a child, so I was really misunderstood, you know, and when it came to being in school, you know, I would always get into conflict. Being the fact that I was always into trouble, you know, as a young child, like I was told I would never make it, you know, the next school I'll go to, I'll get kicked out again. Every school that I went to, I got kicked out of. Probably ended up going to like maybe 5 or 6 schools, you know, all out of town. I got into it with the wrong crowd, you know, as a child, just trying to figure out, you know, who I am and, you know, just try to figure out what America is all about. I lost a lot of friends. That's what really shook me up. It made me realize life is short, you know, you just always gotta be obedient to the word of God, and you know, just try to enjoy every moment of life. Eventually, you know, it clicked on me once I realized that I had a gift in football, you know. So I channeled my energy into football. The end of my sophomore year, I got a phone call from Illinois State. They were called and telling me they were interested in me, and they wanted to know where I was academically. And at the time, I never even knew about a GPA or anything. So I told them, yeah, my academics are good, because all I ever worried about was just going to school. So the next day, I went to my guidance counselor, and he told me my GPA was like a 1.7.
In the end, Andrew did not make it into Illinois State, opening his eyes to the importance of improving his academic career.
That was a changing point where I got my act together. You know, I started going to class more, focusing, you know, started doing work. I made a deal with my with the principal that if I make the dean's list, can I tape my certificate on my locker? He agreed. So every semester of my high school, from sophomore year till I graduated, I made dean's list and I taped it all on my locker. You know, because it was just a point, you know, just to show you guys, hey, I can do this because I want to.
Finally, it all came together on November 1st as he caught the first touchdown of his college career after starting as a wide receiver.
Finally felt the hard work was being paid off. You know, it wasn't the ideal weather scenario that I wanted it to be in, but it, you know, it was just mind over matter. You know, and once I seen the ball in there, I just focused on it, you know, applied all my training techniques and caught the ball and just made sure I ended up in the end zone with the ball. I play for many things, a lot of things, you know. So I'm a true believer that you shouldn't play for one thing or for one person, because if that one thing or one person is gone, then what do you have left to play for? So first and foremost, I definitely play for God first, because without you know, the blessing and the talent that He's given me, you know, I obviously wouldn't be able to play the sport. And of course, I love the game. You know, like this, a lot of people think football is just a game. I understand football is just a game, but at the same time, I make it my life. You know, if football was to go away tomorrow, I'd be able to live my life. Everything that this game has given me is a blessing. So whether it's school, you know, or just meeting new people, you know, new professors, you know, friends, my teammates, you know, I take it all as a blessing, you know, and it's never for granted, you know, and it just, I try to apply it to every aspect of my life, you know, because it all can be taken away at any moment football-wise, but the things that football has given me, those are things that I can cherish, you know, and they'll really apply for my life.
What a journey it's been for Andrew Opoku, finally getting significant time on offense to go along with what he's done throughout the years on special teams. Talk about Andrew.
Yeah, Andrew's done a good job, and you know, we've talked about him before. He and I have a unique relationship, I would say, again, he's got a dynamic story, and really excited that things have gone as well as they have for him in his last year. And you know, we certainly wish him as best we can as he goes forward, and we're looking forward to seeing him be a big success.
All right, it's Senior Day on Saturday. It's Rivalry Week for the Blue Hens. We'll talk about the Villanova Wildcats, their opponent, when we come back.